Hello there, and welcome to another Starfield ship review video. In today's video, we're going to be looking at the Trader Wagon Train 3. So this is the Tier 3 version of the Trader Wagon Train. The number just denotes the tiering system. Aesthetically, all ships will be the same. The tier only really affects the stats of the modules, like the reactor and the jump range. So this tier 3 has a B-cost reactor of 27, whereas a tier 2 may only have 24, and a tier 1 may only have 20. So aside from that, aesthetically, these ships are all exactly the same. So yeah, let's get into it. So there is a non-trader version of the wagon train that I did a review on. This is the trader version, obviously, which... you may have come across these ships if you spend a bit of time in orbit around a planet. It's just an NPC vessel that's meant to kind of fill the role of a trader that you can communicate with, and you can buy stuff off them, or you can also piracy them. It's kind of, I feel like it's more there for people who like to use piracy. I'm assuming it's going to be aesthetically the same. Main difference is the color scheme. The trader ship have these kind of like seafoam green, and then like dark sage, and then blue. Which is pretty interesting. So anyway, let's get into the stats. We've got fuel at 300, which is very good. More than enough cargo, or more than enough fuel, I should say. You'll be able to jump around without having to stop to refuel. It's got a hull of 1015, which is very good for a B-class vessel. Obviously, this is meant to be a cargo vessel, but it could definitely be upgraded to a combat vessel quite easily. It's got a cargo capacity of 3,220, so almost 3.3k, which, as you can see, this main cargo is there in the inside those sections there. And then it also has 380 shielded capacity. Now, for any of you guys that don't know this, shielded capacity basically allows you to transport contraband down to planet surfaces without getting a bounty. Now, it's not foolproof, but the way it would work basically is if you have contraband that weighs less than the shielded capacity, when you are scanned above a planet, there's a probability, a lower probability you won't be detected. Now, that changes based on your perks. I believe there's perks for it. There is also certain, they're like jammers you can buy from the Crimson Fleet that make it give you a better chance of dodging them. So yeah, this is quite a good ship if you haven't ended up joining the Crimson Fleet and you're looking for like a vessel that you can hide some cargo and, you know, if you want to smuggle some Aurora. So stat-wise, or module-wise, we've got a B-class reactor with 27 power. That's not inherently bad, but looking at the configuration, we might have some power issues. I'd probably recommend upgrading that. It's got a crew of 5, which is quite good. It's nice to have a bit more crew, so that this is quite a large vessel compared to the other trader version that I did in the previous videos. So it's just nice having more crew on hand. It's got a 27 light year jump range, which is really good, 3 off a max. It's got 830 shields, which again is quite good. I believe the highest B-class shields in the game is around 1150. Now, if you have the Vanguard quest line done to a certain point, you will unlock a B-class shield that is 1500, but you know, you might not have that, so. And then we've got 2 sets of weapons. We've got 2 laser turrets there at the front and 2 ballistic turrets on the back that I believe are railguns. So this ship, which the fact that you can buy it is quite interesting. I thought, like the other trading vessel, I thought that you would have to steal it, but you don't. So this ship is costing me 275,000 credits and 80 credits. That price will change depending on the tier and your perks. If you have a lower tier version, it'll be cheaper. I'm just going to purchase it. And then I found this ship, this gentleman here wearing the wife beater. We are in Porima on Porima 3. We are in the Red Mile. This is tied to a quest line, but you can come here at any point. So there it is, Porima 3. There is Porima 2 with Paradiso, which you're more familiar with. The Porima system. Here is the Porima system. And then there's Volai over there. And then we have Narian and Cheyenne and Alpha Centauri. So I've only seen these vessels here, the trading vessels. So I would recommend coming here if you want to pick up the ship. And if it's not there, just do the usual. Land on Mercury, wait 24 hours and come back. Anyway, we're going to jump to our usual spot to do the overview. Alright, so here we are at the overview of the vessel. So as you can see, it's pretty much identical to the normal the normal wagon train. Only difference is the color scheme. It's got that really cool color scheme. It's very standout-ish. I like the shape of it. I like that the cargo is kind of protected inside behind the habitat module, which kind of makes me think that we care more about your cargo than our crew. Which, if you're looking for a place to work, might not be the best slogan, but if you're looking for a place to deliver your Amazon, this could be it. It's a tile vessel, looking at the aesthetic, which is quite cool. It means that we should have a lot of stuff to check out. So we've got the tile entryway. Entry is on the starboard side. Look at that. Just gonna actually look here real quick, cause yeah. So like you can kind of unload it here. I'm assuming this like lowers, and you just like drop it off, which is really cool. Anyway, in we go. So tile has the door, which is always nice. As opposed to the ladder. Makes sense, you don't want to be holding stuff out for the ladder. So immediately we are greeted by a Tayo computer core room. Pretty nice, you can keep track of all the stuff you're hauling, make sure you dot your I's and everyone gets their packages on time. For a trading vessel, is probably like, I don't really see the appeal to it personally. You know, it's not a bad to have. And then up here we have a, this I believe is a an all-in-one. No, I believe this is living quarters. We've got a little window here. We'll do a tear down at the end, as always. We got a window here looking out the starboard side. We've got some bunk beds here. We've got a toilet with a door that closes. We have a galley that works. You can make some whatever you want to make, basically. And then we have these like extenders, which we'll go to in a minute. I really like them, they're quite cool. And then back here we have, this is, I believe, the captain's quarters. It's quite like that the captain and the crew kind of live together, it makes sense. Also, from a defensive point of view, if the captain's like sleeping, we've got... No, they gotta get through the crew first. Barrett, you're not the captain. We've got some tea here. Oh, whoops. Ignore that pop-up. I've got some coffee, you know, very fancy. And we've got a little bed here. Ooh.
I want to hear one of my stories?
No.
Or do you have one to tell me?
No, we're good. Got a little desk here. We've got a computer terminal that doesn't work. Some pictures, more storage. And then we've got this little, it's got a little, little kind of area for you to chill with your crew. Why is it just a random plant on the floor? See, the thing with these Tayo vessels is you come in and you're like, this is really cool. You know, it's really nice. But then, I don't know why, I feel like this doesn't really fit with the Tayo aesthetic or Tayo. Like, it just, it doesn't seem like clean and like, you know, Apple-like, you know, very like sterile. But anyway, so if we come through here, through the in the middle, we have a 1x1 storage room. And we'll go up there in a minute. And we walk through here again. We have a workshop. Very nice. We've got Cora there. Let's not make eye contact. She's going to ask me for money.
Reading good books lately?
Okay, she's not. Got a weapon workbench here. We have the industrial workbench. And we have the spacesuit workbench, which is really nice. I said this in the other video too. This is quite... Layout of the ship is quite good. If you want a ship that's very minimal ladders, this is kind of the ship. I just... wish that we had a... Oh, wait a minute. My question is going to be answered. Okay, yes. Yeah, we got a science lab here with the pharmaceutical lab and the research lab. I was going to say, I'm pretty sure other workstations on different habit, like the Deimos one and the Nova Galactic, I believe they also have a research station, but you have it here. So you got a pharmaceutical lab and a research lab. We got some windows here. I don't necessarily know why you would have this on a cargo vessel. Maybe... you know, you're transporting something, like live animals. Maybe you need, like, a doctor on hand. And then if I remember, yeah, we have another lab down here, which I would probably swap this for maybe an infirmary or maybe something else. Yeah, I just don't see why you need two of the same labs. But anyway, let me just... Oh, I got stuck. Nothing else here, is there? Not yet. Also, these chairs, like, come on now. Tayo, I'm paying an arm and a leg. Get some, like, decent, like, you know, some suede, maybe. And if we come back this way, we have... This is the engine room, I believe. 3x1. I'm just gonna double check here. Yeah, this is where we came in. We got... Tayo engine room is quite cool because it's, like, segmented... Oh, that's not the engine room. The Tayo engine room here is quite cool because, like, segmented almost. I was just thinking. Got some storage here. Never mind. It's more, like, uniform than Hope Tech. It's a lot more cleaner. And then we have the... We have a starboard viewing port, and then a port viewing port. And then at the front here, we have a 1x1 storage room with a docking hatch. And then if we come back this way, we have an armory, which is nice to have. This is just the Hope Tech armory. See, some of the Tayo habitats are unique, but then you have just rescan. Like, this is the Hope Tech one. For some reason, you've got a brig here, which... I mean, makes sense. You know, you might need to transport dodgy people. But you also have weapon cases here, which... Yeah, like, the last thing I want is a dude getting a revolver after he breaks out. Anyway, and then if we come back this way, we've got a drop down. Ooh, we have a crew control station. This is really nice. This is where the crew station... Or why the crew limit is up so high. So we got some terminals here for the crew to chill on. And we've got some more credits. And then if we head back this way, and if we come back around, we find the bridge is over this way. Excuse me. And then up here to the bridge. So we've got the Shroud Eklund. This is the Kon-Tiki Bridge, I believe. I love this bridge. The only thing I don't like is these chairs. Honestly, I'd remove these chairs because your crew will sit here and they'll be able to see you and each other and they'll just have constant conversations. It's just very obnoxious. But I really like this bridge. It reminds me of the Lakon bridges from Elite Dangerous. They're like, they make like kind of cargo vessels and it would make sense. You need to be able to see what's going on. From this bridge, I can see the docking port at the top there so that, you know, if I have any issues, I can see it. Yeah, so let's take it off. So I'm not going to be expecting a lot of movement speed from this. I need to get rid of my crew again. Just because it's a trading vessel. I really wish that Tayo sensor on the front wasn't like making it look like the thing has an overbite. But, you know, beggars can't be choosers.
Everything looks so pretty up here.
So we're going to really quickly get rid of my crew. We're going to just... space them just so there's no... There we go. So now, so like I've said in the past, I have a perk that gives me 5 extra power. So for the sake of this review, we're going to be not using that 5 power. So weapon wise we've got lasers and ballistics. They are the turreted weapons. You can't utilize them, but I quite like that they're turreted weapons because I feel like if you're using a trading vessel, you're not going to be using it for combat. You're going to be, if you get into combat, you're going to be trying to outrun them and just flying defensively. So having the turrets that kind of track themselves and do the work is really, really good. So speed-wise, we have a base speed of 150, it looks like, which is really nice. And then we have a boost speed of... boost speed around 600, if that, which is, again, really, really nice. I'm gonna do a quick agility test, do a pitch. Okay, so this is slow. Not extremely slow. I'd say that's maybe like 4. The yaw seems a little bit faster, but that's probably because... Yeah, the yaw's like a 6. And then the roll. Roll is kind of slow itself. Alright, so we're gonna go down to the planet now and do a teardown. Just to show you how it's made. Alright, so here we are. So I stripped it in 2 because that's all it really is. So we have this bridge here that sits up really high. It doesn't sit up high, I just moved it up so you can see. This is the Kon-Tiki B300 bridge. This would sit here like so, but I have moved it just so you can see. And then we have the Tayo storeroom 1x1 top B. We have the Tayo 2x1 top B armory. We have the Tayo engineering bay 3x1 top B. We have the Tayo companionway 1x1 top B. We have the Tayo extender port 200 docker top. And then we have four of these Nova cross passages, two on each side here. And then on this side, we have a Tayo workshop 2x1 top B and a Tayo science lab 2x1 top B. And then over here, we have an all-in-one berth top B and a captain's quarters top B. Now, weaponry, we have a pair of these Scorch P60 megawatt pulse laser turrets from Lightsight. B-class, 1800 range, 5 fire rate, 18 shield damage, and 4 power. And they're mounted on some equipment plates from Tayo. And then we have two more weapons on the back. We have some Jishaku FERF rapid railgun turrets from Shinigami. B-class, 1500 range, 5 fire rate, 18 hull damage, and 3 max power. And again, they're mounted on some equipment plates. So the shield generator is an Osiris 2030 B shield generator from Protectorate Systems. B-class, 8 max power, 830 shield health. Now, if we really quickly see, the B-class, we might have some more. Whoops. So this is the 2030. If we go up to the 2040, this requires 4 starship design. This requires only 3. So we're basically paying 15k for that, 19k. So an extra 4k for the same power requirement, but an extra 165 shield, which is quite a decent jump. Obviously, if you have the Vanguard quest line, you can upgrade to this one. This requires 4 more shield. Doesn't require any perks, and it's 1450, which is really, really good. And then we also have some of these on this one here. This requires 4 again, design Starship 4. This is B-class, 10 power, 1125. So you have some options for, like, shield generators. And then at the back here, we have the engines. We have a pair of these SA-4330 engines from Slayton Aerospace. Only A-class, weirdly. 2 max power, 15-240 engine thrust, and 30-220 maneuvering thrust. So we have 4 of them, 2 on this side. We have 2 of these M40 Ulysses HE3 tanks from Dogstar. They give 150 each. And then for cargo, we have 4 of these Stormax. We have various assortments. So we have a Stormax 50 cargo here that's 320. We have a Stormax 60, which is 435. Another 50, and then we have another 40. So these vary. I'll show you real quick if we go into our... So obviously it looks a little better having the 4 different ones, but if you see, we have 30 there, 40, 50, and then we've 60. Now obviously they look nice, like being different, but if you wanted to maximize your cargo capacity, you could just use these ones. All of the red ones, basically. So for aesthetic pieces, we have a lot of weapon hardpoints. We've got 2 Horizon weapon mount points here at the front. We've got 2 windows here. Porthole starboard from Nova Galactic. We have another porthole top there from Nova Galactic. We have 2 of these. These are the 200cm ballast shielded cargo hold. They're 190 each, shielded from Sextant. So that's where you hide all your stuff. And then we have... We have 3 of these Tayo cowlings, 4 top, like so. And then we've got 2 more windows. It's the same each side, so we've got 2 of these Nova portholes there and there. And then 2 more on the other side. And then we have 2 more of these Horizon weapon mounts, 1 there and 1 there. So you have a lot of potential for weaponry on this vessel. And then we have the cowling aft there. Now if we go down to the middle of the vessel... So, we have the Tayo control station 2x1 bottom there. We have Tayo computer core 2x1 bottom there. We have the ship 2 bed 200 landing bay. And then over here we have the second science lab. Now, I would swap this out for something else. I don't believe there's any Tayo habitats being sold here. Yeah, there's not. But you could easily swap it. Let me swap it. Oh, it will. Okay, so you could swap it for... Potentially an infirmary, maybe. Be nice to have. And then for the... Do we have any more? Nope. Okay, so again, for the cargo, we have more of these. Some various ones here. Obviously, like I was saying, you could just use only these ones if you want the max storage. reactor. We have the DC-302 fast ignition reactor from Deep Core. This is a B-class, 27 power. Now, I know for a fact we can get a better one, so if we come down here... So we can swap this out for the 303, which gives us 35 power, an extra 8 power. It requires you to have piling 3 and design 4, and it costs an extra 13k, but 35 power was going to be really nice. And then we have this RD-3000 beta grav drive from Relidyne, B-class, 10 max power, 36 grav jump thrust. Now I feel like you're going to be hard-pressed to find a better one. You can double-check, though. Yeah, you're going to be hard-pressed to find a B-class above 36 power. You're kind of breaking into the sea if you want that sort of power. And then for engines, just to double check, because sometimes ships have different engines. Yeah, we've got the same set of engines here. They're just, they've been flipped. So you can, like, modify them. And then for the aesthetic pieces on this, we have two of these Tayo cowlings. We've only one Tayo cowling here. And then we have a Tayo braking engine here. We have a pinpoint 4G landing gear here. We have another pinpoint 4G landing gear there. We have a Tayo spine beat, another pinpoint landing gear there. We have another two pinpoint landing gear there and there. And then we have a Nova bracer there. And then finally, we have the Tayo cowling aft bottom. So I'm going to put it back together real quick. So it's, all in all, it's a very cool ship. If I was to upgrade it, what I would, like I was saying, what I would do is I would... Let me just go back. So currently cargo capacity is 3200. Now if we were to take out all these and replace them with I know that we want them lined up the way they were, and then some there, and then two more here. So we've basically jumped up to almost another 1k cargo, which is really nice. Now, as for weaponry, like, this is quite an effective combat ship, weirdly. You wouldn't think it with a trader vessel. So what I'd probably do is I would take off these turret weapons, because you don't need... If you're going to go turreted, you want to go particle. So what I would probably do is weaponry. If we're going turreted, I would recommend having a pair of... Where are they? Come on now. I know you're there somewhere. So we have a couple of options here. So we've got... So these, we've got these auto turrets here from P... I really like these ones just because... Yeah. But from an aesthetic point of view, they don't really look very nice. Then we've got these ones here. So the main difference is these fire slower, but they do 29 damage. Whereas these fire faster, but they do 16. So these do slightly more damage, not as much range. So I'm going to go with these ones. So I'd slap two of these here at the front, like so. Actually, you know what I do? I'd slap one there. One there. And then I'd move this over to here. And I would slap another one there, like so. So that would be if I was laying out three. Now, if you're going four, you could easily put two more there. If that was the case, if you were going to do four, I'd recommend putting these ones backwards, just so they'll shoot backwards. And then, they'll be doing the majority of the work, but if you want to kind of, you know, do a bit of damage. So what I would recommend doing is get some of these bad boys here. So we have, you know them, you love them. So I'd probably use some of these here. So we could slap four of them on there on the front if we wanted to. Just so we could shoot ourselves. Not shoot ourselves, but, you know, like shoot control weapons. Now this current config, we're just going to really quickly... Obviously, in this current configuration, she's a bit... Come on now, what are you doing? Ah, oh, there we go. There we go. So this is using 40 power as is in the current configuration. So you'd have to be a little bit careful with the power. So obviously, if we upgrade the reactor, there's the reactor there. I'm gonna upgrade the reactor. Come here, reactor. We're gonna put this bad boy in here. So we've got a 35 power currently. So I would probably, like I said, I would probably use three turrets just for the sake of basically trying to keep your reactor a bit better. So I'd only do three there, like so. And then for these weapons here, I'd probably only do two if it was up to me. Now that keeps your power down at 31. And then that would give us enough power to upgrade to this shield here. Perfect. So in this current configuration, we have exactly the amount of power we require to do everything. Now, the thing is, we probably see, I can't remember off the top of my head, because when it's showing how much power you're using, I can't remember if it actually takes into the grav drive. Because if it is taking into grav drive, you could definitely put four the turrets there. As for like storage is kind of fine the way it is. Like you have to remember, you want this to be mainly a tra like a hauling vessel, so you don't want to like fully kit out. Like I wouldn't put three sets of weapons. I'd have just the turrets because you know they do their job. And then, yeah, that's really it. I wonder actually, hold on now, let me just see some. I'd probably move the bridge forward if it was up to me. What's the error? Ship has no touch modules. Yeah, I'd probably move the bridge forward just because you get a bit more view, personally. Plus, it looks a bit different than the, you know, the normal rail star too. And then yeah, we could. Let me see. Now these engines, I believe, probably not gonna be able to. Could we actually? Oh, let me see here. Do we have any other engines we could add just to give it a little bit more thrust? These require two power. Perfect. Damn it. Let's try to see if we have anything. I don't think we have. Oh, these require three. Yeah, see, there's not. Oh, maybe actually. Hold on now. We could potentially put one of these down. Gives a little bit more maneuverability. Gonna be too long. Forty-two. So yeah, so you could tear out that back section and add this. This would give you a little bit more maneuverability. Obviously, you're sacrificing a little bit of jump range, but for the most part, you're probably better off not really doing that. I'd just keep it as is. But as for everything else, like I said, I'd probably strap on a little bit more turrets, swap them out for these sort of particle turrets or any particle turrets. And then have some of these particle beams just so you can, when you feel bored, you can shoot some stuff. Anyway, that was the ship review. Hope you guys enjoy this. Let me know in the comments if you've flown this vessel or the non-trader version. I'm assuming if you've. Did you guys know that it was for sale? Because I didn't. I was kind of shocked when I see it on sale. But yeah, so let me know, like I said, let me know if you've flown it, how you've modified it, if you have modified it, or if you just kept it stock. As always, thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to check out some of my other reviews and subscribe if you're interested in this sort of content. Bye-bye.